On this video, we will examine the science behind the taste and smell of food. Is it only our imagination? We are going to find out next. So do not forget to subscribe Foodie Eyes channel and comment on this special video, because we are starting right now. Why do people have different reactions to the same food? One person might love chocolate, while another person might find it too sweet. Some people love cheese, but others just think it's nasty. The reason for these differences is due in large part to the taste of food. But there are other factors. The smell of food, its texture, its color, and its temperature also contribute to what's generally known as the flavor of food. The combination of all these factors tells us whether food is delicious, good, unpleasant, or downright disgusting. The flavor of food is due mostly to how it tastes and smells. When you eat, the most immediate sensation is taste, but you actually smell the food as well. If you hold your nose while you eat, you will notice that some foods will taste different. There are five taste sensations: sweet, bitter, sour, salty, and umami. The last one only recognized as a taste in 1985. Umami is associated with savory foods, which includes meat and tomatoes. So the smell is important, and even more important than the taste. For instance, when people who have a head cold try to taste salsa and chips, for example, they feel the textural crunch of the chips and the tingle of the hot peppers on their tongue, but they cannot taste the salsa-rich flavor with its onions, tomatoes, and peppers, because they cannot smell it. When we chew, aromas are released to activate our sense of smell by track of a special channel that connects the roof of the throat to the nose. If this channel is blocked, such as when our noses are stuffed up by a cold, flu, or other surprises, odors cannot reach the sensory cells in the nose that are stimulated by smell, so we don't enjoy the foods in the same way. Without smell, foods tend to taste bland and have no flavor. A huge amount of chemical compounds contribute to the flavor of food. Chocolate, for instance, is a mixture of some 300 flavor compounds, and coffee beans contain more than 800 chemicals. Identifying these chemicals can help create a variety of artificial flavors that are used in nearly every food product out there, including potato chips, ice cream, and soft drinks. Chemists create artificial flavors from chemical compounds which present in plants and animals. They use them in their natural state, or they process them to make new flavors. What's interesting is that we don't need all the flavor compounds in a given food to recreate its flavor. For instance, an orange contains 250 flavor chemicals, which all combine to create an orange flavor. But artificially flavored powdered drink mix has only 6 aromatic chemicals in its makeup, but it has a familiar orange taste. So we can get pretty close to proper orange flavors from just a few of its flavor chemicals. Artificial flavors get their characteristic odor from various compounds, especially esters, which are chemical compounds formed by the chemical reaction of an alcohol with a carboxylic acid. Alcohol is an organic compound with the general formula of ROO and H. A carboxylic acid is a compound with the general formula RCOOH, One of the compounds that gives pineapple its flavor is produced through the reaction of butanoic acid with ethanol. But wait a second, isn't ethanol the type of alcohol found in alcoholic beverages? That's true, but when it combines with the acid, it loses the characteristic of alcoholic drink. Likewise, acetic acid is the main component of vinegar. Yet, when it reacts with an alcohol, the flavor changes dramatically. When two compounds react to form a new compound, the properties of the new compound are not a simple combination of those original ones. They are completely different. If you use different alcohols and different acids, you obtain different flavors. You can compare that to combining two colors of paint. When you combine red and yellow, you get orange. Similarly, when you combine pentanol with acetic acid, you get a pentyl acetate, an ester that smells a lot like a banana. Flavor chemists combine many chemicals to achieve the desired set day after day. They test different combinations before setting on the one that will achieve the desired result. But don't expect to get a tour of flavor and fragrance in the factory. At major food companies, you have to work as an apprentice chemist for 7 years before you even getting a peek at the flavor formulas behind the world's most popular foods. So subscribe Foodie Eyes and get the best foodie videos to your main screen. Thanks for watching, see you on the next!